Hello, fella.
Para guapa, hoy me encargo yo. Toma 200 cenis y vete a comprar unos mochi al Costco. Encantado de conocer, soy Chaos Ledger y antes de seguir con el vídeo quería decir una cosa en mi propia voz. Thank you, you are. He llegado este fin de semana a los 15.000 suscriptores, que se dice pronto. Cosa que me llena de mucha alegría y gratitud hacia vosotros. Siento mucho que no pueda hablar con una persona normal en inglés y, según mi logopeda, español tampoco. Uso normalmente esta voz de máquina para poder llegar al mayor número de personas posible y agradezco a todos vosotros que me seguís a pesar de esta limitación. Bueno, la verdad es que tampoco es que sea hombre de muchas palabras en castellano, así que lo dicho. Muchas gracias a todos. Sigo con el tema del vídeo. Mi retrospectiva de la actualización 2.0, cómo ha cambiado las galas, me niego rotundamente a decir lanzapistola, y qué es lo que espero de ella en la versión 3.0. Ale, chata, sigue con lo tuyo.
Thanks. And don't interrupt me never again, you big jerk. I have never seen in my life a patch change so much the state of a weapon than this update. And more than the gunlands introduced, it was two big factors. Bagel Goose armor and the missing craftable decorations. In 1.0 was almost impossible to do a good build decent for both shelling and melee without a godlike charm. You could get at most between 90 and 100 affinity devoting your whole set into it and that was all, sacrificing all your extra skills like evade extender or guard. Didn't help at all that every single armor with weakness exploit sucked. You had to get a weakness exploit 2 charm or forget about a gunlance melee build. Even doing a shelling build was tricky. You couldn't dream about having Wirebug Whisperer 3, Guard 5 and Evade Extender 3 all together in a single build. You were forced to use Renoplo's arms and Nargacuga belt regardless of what you build. Bagel armor changed all that. Every single piece of armor is optimal or near optimal if you want artillery, load up and guard in your build. The only 3 armor pieces that you can justify changing are the helm, chest and arms. Otherwise you are throwing guard points away for nothing in exchange. And you get a lot of flexibility thanks for these armor pieces, basically you can do any build you dream. Especially with the craftable decorations. Protective Polish, Good Luck and Weakness Exploit are the most game-changing decorations introduced for gunlance. Protective Polish allows you to keep small poles of blue and white sharpness being the biggest damage bonuses you will have for the least cost. Even with shelling spending now only 1 point per shell, Gunlance still eats through sharpness so fast that Protective Polish is usually superior to Razor Sharp. Skill that also got decorations. Weakness Exploit decos are straightforward. You no longer need a Weakness Exploit charm but you can roll easier to get Evade Extender or Wirebug charms, makes DPS build much easier to do. And finally Good Luck is great for the few people who are still only using shelling attacks. Maximizing your rewards when you can't do more damage. That is the biggest shift in the update 2.0. Shelling did peak in 1.0 and we didn't get any kind of upgrade in 2.0 while at the same time going for extra melee damage is easier than ever. Conclusion, every shell-based build is now weak. The biggest loser of all is the previous big fish of 1.0, Wormsteak Lance. I'm half grateful for this because it was too good and you had little reason to use other builds. But now is nowhere as good as the rest and the flaws show up as being a kind of melee attack that doesn't benefit from melee attack bonuses. Wormsteak is now a mid-commitment attack that does mediocre damage. Why use this when you can slam full burst sweep that has similar commitment for a lot more damage? If Wormsteak is weak, then, everything shell related that was already weaker, now is worse. Wyvernfire is an actual damage loss in everything but long where it matches the damage of the full burst combo. Charged shells themselves were already weak and now that you can get very good poke shell damage and Wormsteak is weak, you get much less reason to use them. And the weirdest of all, uncharged shells aka the poke shell combo now greatly loses against full bursting. Even with a wide gunlance. This one is because we didn't get any spectacular wide gunlance. We only got one extra wide 5 gunlance and while is generally better than Corn Popper is a water-based one that can't compete against the powerhouse than are the level 4 ones. Baryote and Tigrex gunlances got a final upgrade that leaves all others behind because of their exceptional 40% affinity or second highest raw with white sharpness. That are only optimal if you use the melee only slap lance. Because normal type got the jackpot with the Eric Nalance being great at everything but Raw. Eric Nalance is the premium example of how everybody overvalues the Raw of a weapon. The strongest Gunlance in the game only has 170 Raw. But that is more than overcompensated with 25% natural affinity, a slot for even more damage and natural white. Plus good ramp up skills, especially Wyvern Exploit. Basically there is no contest in what is the best melee Gunlance of all. Full bursting in Rise is also the best never has been thanks to Blast Dash allowing to burst the fastest never has been and negating the range disadvantage. The only real good wide Gunlance is of all things Puke Gunlance because poison is crazy in this game. Camellia's armor basically doubles your poison damage. With it, every time it procs, you will end up doing 560 damage. In a single activation. This is equivalent to 4.6 blast explosions. That is what you are likely to get in a whole hunt using Buzzle Gunlance. Puke with Camellia's build can get an absurd 70 poison value that is worth from 4 to 5 activations. I haven't done the formal calculations but basically it is equivalent to add 20 damage to each of your pokes. And is damage that is not dependent on the hit zones you are hitting. I didn't have time to calculate how it compares against Eric Nalance. But get my words. If the Elder Dragon Blessing skills become available in charms or decorations, poison will be the strongest thing in the game. Same if Camellia's or the Rampage Gunlance's end being wide 5. And shelling gets some kind of compensation. Because without getting into the comparison with the other weapons, where the situation is also dire in the lowest ranks, the current balance of Gunlance is awful. Full bursting is the strongest combo for all shell types. Wormstake is something you only do now after a successful guard edge. Wyvern Fire is a trap. And doesn't matter because it still has that awful recovery time. And poke shelling only see any use for applying status. This also has a side effect of making the switch skills of charged shell, hail cutter and guard reload even worse. Charged shells are nothing without Wormstake. Remember also supercharged shells being a huge failure. When Blast Dash is the main reason why lots of people are playing Gunlance right now, can't compete at all. Hail Cutter is back to its 100% useless place because Long is not longer the top dog and Wyvern Fire lacking damage even with the damage bonus. And Guard Reload is incompatible with Full Burst only getting some use with wide Gunlance. It is still useful and good but got a lot more niche. We need a change. Or things are going to get even worse. We are so close to Slaplance being the only way to play Gunlance. And what Capcom has to do is nothing. Because Melee gets better in each update. They will introduce stronger Gunlances, stronger skills and more slots to making slotting skills easier. And shelling will stay the same and fall more and more with each update. Unless something is done. I'm trying to push in Twitter the hashtag save Gunlance to raise awareness of how while the situation is not terrible now. It can get worse and will be worse. Unless something is done. But I'm sure that even if nothing is done, shelling will be strong enough to carry you against the incoming monsters. I got a lot of surprise builds from this update. I wasn't expecting Puke Gunlance be this good and the Zombie Gunlance built using Kushala Blessing is a blast. In fact, I'm going to tackle update 3.0 using the Zombie Gunlance and face rolling monsters. Because even without skills, Gunlance shelling is still strong and Eric Nalance can carry me until I get the materials to upgrade my equipment. And these are my hopes, dreams and doubts about the upcoming update. Do you share them? Whatever it happens we will know in about 2 days. I can't wait. Do you? See you in the hunt.